Hey Angular folks, it's Brian. After many years of building with Angular, I'm here to help you level up your skills and build better apps. Ever built a read more component that just brutally chops off content mid-sentence? Yeah, we've all been there. Today, I'm showing you how to build a smooth, expandable content component in Angular that actually looks professional. We'll start with a toggle that does absolutely nothing visual and transform it into something with elegant height transitions and a subtle fade effect. And we'll do it all using Angular's newest features, signals, and the new control flow syntax. Okay, let's turn this sad excuse for a component into something you'd actually want to show off. We have a super basic Angular application, and you can see we have this content that needs to toggle. But currently, when we click the button, all that happens is the text changes between more and less. That's literally all it does right now. So let's fix this and make it actually do something meaningful. Before we dive in, you might be wondering, hey, doesn't HTML have a details element for this? Good question. While details summary is great for simple show hide functionality, we want something more flexible. Arbitrary content starting at any height, smooth animations, and a subtle fade effect. Think of this as the details element's cooler, more customizable cousin. Okay, let's start by understanding what we're working with. I'll switch to the toggle height component template. Here we have an article element that contains a generic content slot. This will put whatever content the parent component gives us right here. Below that, we have our footer with the button that calls the toggle method when clicked. Then we have either a less or more label based on whether the component is expanded, which is tracked with an isExpanded signal. Now let's switch to the component TypeScript file to see what's happening under the hood. Here's our isExpanded signal. It's initialized to false, so we start collapsed. And here, we're already binding a class on the host when this isExpanded signal is true. We'll need to use this in a minute. Finally, we have the toggle method that's used to toggle the value of the isExpanded signal. So this is a great starting point, but here's the problem. We're not actually doing anything with this expanded state except changing the button text. Time to fix that. Let's start making this component actually expandable. First, I'm going to add a new input called collapsed height, and I'll provide a default value of 50 pixels. This makes our component configurable. Different instances can have different collapsed heights depending on their needs, and if we don't provide a custom height, it will be 50 pixels tall. Now, we can use style binding to add a custom property on the host using this input value. CSS custom properties are like variables in CSS, but the cool part is we can even set them dynamically from JavaScript. We'll use this in our component styles in a minute as part of the overall expand collapse strategy. Okay, to make this work properly, we need to be able to measure the actual height of our content. And to do that, we need a reference to the DOM element. Let's switch to the HTML template and add a template reference variable to our article. Let's call it container. This gives us a way to access this specific DOM element from our TypeScript code. Now, let's switch back to the component TypeScript to wire this all up. Let's add a new property called container. We'll use the viewchild function to access the element. This item will be required, and it will be typed as an element reference. Then we can use our container reference label as the selector. In this case, viewchild is Angular's way of saying, give me direct access to that DOM element. Think of it like getting a backstage pass. Instead of just seeing the element from the audience, we can go behind the scenes and actually measure it, manipulate it, whatever we need. Next, I need a signal to track our expanded height. It'll either be a string or null, and we'll initialize it to null. Next, we can bind another custom property for this value on the host so that we can access it from the component styles as well. Now I need to update the toggle method to actually calculate the expanded height. We'll use the set method to set this value, but we're going to set it based on whether the component is expanded or not. If we are expanded, we'll set the value to the scroll height of the article. This gives us the total height of the content, including any content that's currently hidden due to overflow. Scroll height is like asking the browser, hey, if this element could show all its content without any restrictions, how tall would it be? It's perfect for this use case because it tells us exactly how tall our element needs to be to show all its content. Then, if we're collapsed, I'll set it back to null, which will remove the custom property from the host entirely. Now, let's take a look at the component CSS. Currently, the article just has overflow hidden, which prevents content from spilling out. But now I need to actually control the height. Let's set the height using our collapsed height custom property. Now I need to add styles for when we're expanded. For this, let's use the host selector with the expanded class, and then we'll add the article. Now, whatever styles we add here will apply to our article, but only when the host has the expanded class. So here, let's set the height using the expanded height custom property. Okay, I think that should be all we need, so let's save and see how it works. Moment of truth? Boom! Look at that smooth expansion. That's what I'm talking about. And then, if we want this to start out taller in this particular case, we can switch over to the root component where it's included and add a custom value using our input. Let's go with 120 pixels. Okay, let's save this and see how it looks. Perfect. Now you can see more content initially, and when we click more, it expands to show the full text. All right, phase one complete. We have basic expanding. Now for phase two, making it actually look good. Here comes the fun part. We're about to turn this basic toggle into something that would make even the most picky designer happy. Right now, the content just gets cut off abruptly, which looks a bit harsh. Let's add a nice fade effect to make it more elegant. I'm going to add a mask image using a linear gradient to create a fade out effect at the bottom of the collapsed content. We're going from fully opaque black to transparent, which means the content will gradually fade out over the last 1.5 em of height. Then I need to add a mask size for this to make sure it fits the content properly. And finally, I need to use the mask position property to position this mask at the bottom of the container. By the way, if you want to dive deeper into CSS masks, I have another video that can really help. Masks are incredibly powerful once you understand them. Now, if we were to leave this as is, when we expand the content, we're showing everything, but the fade effect will still be there. That means the last bit of content will still fade out, even in the expanded state. Let's fix this by adding some padding to the expanded state. Okay, while we're here, let's make this transition smooth instead of jarring. Let's animate both the height change and the padding change over a quarter second with an ease timing function. This should make it all feel much more polished. Okay, let's save and check out the final result. Perfect. Look at this beautiful smooth transition. The content fades out elegantly when collapsed. And when I expand it, everything slides down smoothly with no jarring cuts. And when I collapse it again, that fade effect makes it look like the content is gracefully disappearing rather than being brutally chopped off. And there you have it. We transformed a useless toggle into a polished, reusable component using Angular's modern features and a little CSS magic. Try adding different fade effects or transitions. The possibilities are endless. If this helped, give it a like, tell all your friends, and subscribe for more Angular tips and tricks. Until next time, thanks for watching.